able to shoot a web and swing around on buildings like Spider-Man would change your life. These people are attempting to be just like Spidey by building their own web shooters. Even though some of them have gotten close, none have been able to do this. In the movie Spider-Man Homecoming, we see high schooler Peter Parker creating web shooters with just a couple of notes and some chemistry supplies, resulting in the ability to swing around New York City with ease. So that got us thinking, with enough time, money, and resources, would it be possible to make these web shooters that we see in the movies? Or is this just the work of science fiction? Well, believe it or not, building something like this might actually be possible. On today's episode of In Real Life, we're going to show you. Unless you're living under a rock, you probably know what the Spider-Man web shooters are. You've seen them in the comics, movies, and video games. They allow Spider-Man to swing around with ease. They're strong enough to throw baddies around and even stop a train. Anyone can wear the mask, but if you wanted to build one of these, you'd need some incredibly strong materials. But before we get to that, we should first look at what other people have made. These web shooters from Hero Tech used a 3D printed model, a spring, and some magnets to make a functional web shooter. Although instead of sticky web material, they opted for a string and a magnet. This string hook from Built IRL allows him to swing around on poles with ease and even supports his own body weight. Now, these are pretty cool, but let's be honest, they're far from what we see in the movies. So if you wanted to make the real deal, what would you need and how would you build it? Well, building our base would be pretty straightforward, at least in theory. Building something like this that can shoot out a flexible, strong, and sticky material can be done. You'd just probably need a degree in mechanical engineering or the bank account of Tony Stark.
You're in dire need of an upgrade.
But with enough money and brain power, the base of these web shooters would be relatively simple. You could even make them voice activated.
Spiderweb.
And once you make a device that can shoot webs, the real problem lies in what you put into it. Let's take a closer look at the web shooters we see in Spider-Man Homecoming. We can see that Spidey's web shooters are able to support the superhero, web up criminals, and even hold up a ferry that's broken in half. Now, part of this is clearly attributed to Peter Parker's super strength, and unfortunately, we won't be able to make that for you, at least not in this episode, but even without his super strength, these webs are incredibly powerful. Based on what we've seen in the comics and movies, we can assume his webs can withstand a tension of at least 40,000 newtons. Newtons are a way to measure the force of an object. 40,000 newtons basically just means that these things are really strong.
Language!
For comparison's sake, a steel cable is only 6,500 newtons. So, what would be a material that's flexible, as well as strong enough to sustain these kinds of forces? Well, before we get to that, movie fact. Did you know that the webs in Spider-Man Homecoming were entirely CGI? Yeah, instead of making sticky webs, the production decided to use wires and ropes to support the lead actor Tom Holland. So, unfortunately, we can't take much inspiration from the production of the movie, but your Spidey senses are probably tingling and telling you to put spider silk in your web shooters. But that can't be realistic, can it? How can something that comes out of an arachnid support the weight of a human? Well, with enough of it, it actually can be strong enough.
You serious?
Pound for pound, spider silk is stronger than steel. And with just a few millimeters of it twisted up, it can easily be strong enough to support a human. And the thicker your web shooter strings get with spider silk, the stronger they become. And you won't have to pull it out of spiders either. In 2019, scientists figured out how to make this stuff from scratch. They're even trying to make bulletproof skin out of the silk, as it's one of the strongest and most flexible materials we know of. The only problem is that for your web shooters to be strong enough, they'd need to be pretty thick. And with that, you wouldn't be able to carry as much web, which would probably leave you stranded in Central Park somewhere.
This sucks!
So, combined with our flexible and sticky spider silk, we'll reduce the size of the load and replace some of the silk strength with carbon nanotubes. This lightweight material is incredibly strong and you won't need much of it. The only problem is that it's also extremely expensive at $1,000 per gram. So get ready to go to the bank of Mr. Stark again.
Mr. Stark, it smells like a new car in here!
So yeah, it looks as if the web shooters we see in Spider-Man Homecoming could actually exist IRL. Granted, you wouldn't be able to make them in a high school chemistry class, but with enough money and resources, it could be done. So, your fantasy of being the friendly neighborhood Spider-Man lives on. What would you even do if you had these? Bungee jump? Pick up things from a distance? Maybe stop crime? Whatever you do, just remember,
with great power comes great responsibility.
What other movies are you curious about diving deeper into and seeing if they could exist in real life? I'm wondering if you really wanted to, could you make a lightsaber? Well, we'll see if that's possible on the next episode of In Real Life.